Welcome to Magic Duels. I'm your host, Lostwolfe. This is Liliana's story. A little introduction here. You're Liliana Vess, and you come on the planet Dominaria. Oh, let's try it again. You're Liliana Vess, and your corner of the planet Dominaria is embroiled in a war that has consumed your family. Your studies of healing magic are useful, but the ravages of war draw you to the forbidden arts. After all, why should any tool be off-limits in such times? And this sets us up for exactly why I don't like Liliana. You know, if she's a healer, she shouldn't be going here. But anyway, so we have the beginning of a story here. We're going to try and do the end step again. We'll see how we go. If it doesn't work out, that's all right. You're learning a little bit about it as we go every kind of time we do this, so it's all good. Your brother Josu has returned from the battlefield, mortally wounded. Desperate to save him, you are told of a healing poultice by the mysterious Raven Man. But instead of curing him, the potion transforms your brother into an undead horror, intent on killing you. Oh, this looks alright. Okay, welcome to this edition of Black. In this edition of Black, when they released it to us, it had a bunch of sort of slow cards. So this is good, right? But then, like, all of these guys, like, a lot of them just come in to play tapped, and it's just, anyway. So, that sounds good. Are you a zombie? Yes. 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 Okay. So, we are going to try and make you first before we make zombies that can die. But it depends on how fast he goes. Okay. This is a great zombie sacrifice outlet. How comfortable? I guess I'm comfortable doing this. He's gonna tap. I'm not gonna feel obliged to use him for anything other than watching him sit there. Because if he's not tapped, I can't use him to block. Okay, flying and lifelink. Ew. Alright. And again, just so that we don't get suckered into accidentally blocking. So here we go. What is lifelink? Lifelink is a word that says that whenever he does damage to me, he gets the amount of health back to him equal to this guy's attack value. So any damage that is dealt by this creature also causes you to gain that much life. So if he deals 6 damage, he gets 6 life. If he's dealing 1 damage, he gets 1 life. Okay, yeah. Sure. And now we're gonna make our friend over here and we're gonna start blocking. Okay. Interesting, it didn't attack with a flying guy. When Highway Robber enters the battlefield, target opponent loses 2 life and you gain 2 life. Okay, so let's start by attacking. And let's see if he blocks. Probably not at this point. Okay, so we have a 1-1 and a 2-2. I'm gonna kill the 2-2. Am I? No, I'm gonna kill the 1-1. Why am I gonna kill the 1-1? Because it's flying and we don't have any guaranteed way of knowing whether or not we're gonna see the more flying out of him, or whether this will get bigger. So we're gonna deal the damage to that one. Now, as the attacker, I'm the guy doing attacking, I have the ability to put the damage where I want, but I only have 2 points to distribute. I'm distributing one here, which will kill this, and one here, which won't kill this. He's gonna deal three back to me, two there, and one here. And so this guy, who has a toughness of three, is gonna die. But I want you to watch the highway robber very carefully. Okay, that seems good. Okay, right now, as you can see, the highway robber's at 2-1, right? He still has that damage on him. We're gonna put down this. And then we're gonna put down this. Okay. So one of the things that I said about the end of turn is that when there's damage on a creature, remember there's two little steps here. There is the end step, and there is the cleanup step, the one that's just beyond that. And in the cleanup step, the game checks how many cards you have in your hand. If you have more than seven, you discard down. If there's damage on creatures, any kind of damage at all, then the damage wears off, and they get healed for the full amount of health that they have. So, before he does anything else, we can see now that this is a 2-2 again, because that single point of damage that was dealt to him has been healed. Oh, interesting. How big are you? You're a 3-2. I'm gonna put you in the way. And then I'm going to use your ability. I can sacrifice a creature and then it gets +2/+2. And I'm going to sacrifice this because when it dies, he discards a card at random. You are the guy I'm targeting. What did he discard? Oh, Last Kiss. Okay, good. That is excellent. And damage gets dealt. This is now a 4-4. Now, again, what's going to happen here is this is a 4-2, and dependent on how this was stacked, if this became a 2-2 again, it would die. But this is a state-based thing. It says until end of turn. So at the end of turn, remember there are two parts to the end of turn: end step and cleanup. You could, if you had more priority over this, organize it so that it stays at 4-4 and then it heals and it becomes a 2-2 because this temporary power and toughness bonus wears off. But you don't have to worry about that since you have priority. It's sort of kind of assumed that that is what you would do, and so this guy becomes a 4-4, stays a 4-4 until the end of the turn. The healing happens first, so he becomes a 4-4, then he drops down to a 2-2, and he lives. There you go, he lives. Right, now, because we're mean and evil, I'm gonna go get my black cat again. Now, one thing I like to do, but it's not strictly a good idea, is I like to get my grave diggers into the graveyard so I can go and get them back. It's not strictly a good idea though, and he can just team block there. I think what we're going to do, because he has a 5-3, we're going to block here and here. Remember that every zombie that dies helps us. Oh, no attacks. Interesting. Okay. Yeah, I was wondering if we wouldn't have another flying guy. Hey! That's pretty good. Okay, so let's make the black cat. And let's make this guy. He's going to be very good because he's going to help us manage the flying people. I can get you to be a 6-6. That's 5, 6, 7. That doesn't help. I guess we will sit. I was thinking about making him discard his card, and I'm going to do it now, in fact. Discard your card, friend. Oh, it was a land. Okay. I think part of me thinks that what I should do is I should kill the 2-2, and the way I do that, incidentally, is I would shoot him with this. So I'd sacrifice the husk, kill that, bring it back, do it again. But I wonder if it doesn't behoove me. I think we will sit. Because I want to see if he doesn't attack with a flying guy. Because if he attacks with a flying guy, I'll almost certainly do that. Because then the flying guy is tapped. No flying guy attack. Interesting. Aha, okay. This is pretty good. So, what this does is, it destroys target non-zombie creature. It can't be regenerated. Return up to one target zombie card from your graveyard to your hand. So this is all upside, almost. Are you a zombie? Boo, you are. Are you a zombie? No. This is an instant, so we're going to hang on to it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to kill this, and we'll get back. Yeah, we'll get back the black cat. Maybe what we should do is all in very quickly, just with a husk attack, see how he blocks. And then kill a bunch of guys. Okay, so this is kind of what I thought he would do. I'm going to assign the damage to this guy first. And then this guy. And then this guy. Now, what we need to do is we need to sacrifice. So, the first thing that we're going to do is going to make our life a little bit easier. We're going to sacrifice. And we're going to kill off the flying guy. Where are you? Yeah. Okay. So that makes me a 4-4. I guess I should Yeah, I'm gonna 4-4. We're gonna do it again. That makes me a 6-6. This is 5, 6, 7, 8. I need to be 10. Oh, boo. I have to sacrifice this as well. Oh, I didn't want to do that. Oh, well. That's 2, 4, 6. Actually, let me just watch the animation here quickly. Because I think I'm at 6. 4. 6. Yeah, I'm gonna have to sacrifice my whole team. Haha! 8. And then 10. Because I need to survive, otherwise, there's no point in doing what I'm doing. There we go. Oh, I over-sacrificed. Oh well, that's okay. Let's go get a zombie again. We'll go get you. Yes. This also inadvertently helped us because it lowered his life total. Oh. Land. I'm always worried whenever they have a card because I don't know what it's going to be. What is this? As an additional cost alters dream, sacrifice a creature. Two or two cards. I don't think I want to do that. Well, no, I do actually. Let's do this. And then next turn we'll sacrifice it. We'll sacrifice this guy. This is a good introduction to black, by the way, because it's showing you that black generally plays with its graveyard, and it does like messy things where it goes and grabs stuff from other graveyards, or that's the kind of thing black does, and pinpoint removal. So this is a sort of good introduction to how they work. How the color works, I should say. Ugh, okay. So now my plan is a little different. My plan now. Okay, well, this is gonna take him down a little bit. I want to see what's at the top of my deck. Oh, that's good. And kind of awkward. Another shade. Ah, goodness gracious. Not gonna attack, there's no point quite yet. Okay. Discard a card, each other player loses 2 life, you gain life equal to the life loss this way. Sure. Thankfully, I've gotten rid of all of his cards that matter. Here is what I think we should do. We're gonna start making a human chain. Haha. I want you. Confirm. And we're just gonna keep grave digging until we can't anymore, which means we're gonna go grab this next, and then we'll probably grab this. I don't know. I have no attacks quite yet. Interesting. Ah, this is very good. Hooray. So now whenever I sacrifice a zombie, I get two. So what I think I'm gonna do here, there's no point really in having more than one husk on the table. So we're gonna sacrifice you. I'm gonna go grab two cards. I should have done it the other way around. I should have seen what I got first before I did anything like that, but oh well. Hey, land. All right. Okay. Oh, which target creature though? Oh, I'm gonna have to eat one of these. Didn't want to do that. And that was sort of a response there. I did that so that he wouldn't get the life. Hey, black cat. All right, let's put our funny, hilarious plan into action. We want to go get the gravedigger. Yes. Then I want to play the gravedigger. And now I'm pretty sure that I can win just by killing him through life loss. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab the other vengeful dead, and then we're just gonna start sacrificing. He's gonna be a sacrifice party. Oh, interesting, he has a card in his hand. That's perfect because I have a black cat in my hand. I should have done it the other way around, actually. Okay, so let's figure out what that card was. You, sir, feel free to discard. Hey, it was land. And he takes damage. So now what I'm gonna do is we're gonna sacrifice one of the grave diggers. So either now I can run in and kill him, but I think it's funnier to do damage to him, so I'm gonna just sacrifice my dude and win. And here we go. And this is one of the things I don't really like about this. So she turns evil, obviously, as a result of what she did. The dark magic you have been exploring saves you from Josu. But your brush with death is overwhelming. And you feel the world around you dissolve away. A moment ago, you were standing in the ruins of the best manor. Of best manor. But now, you find yourself in an unknown cemetery. On an unknown plane. Right, and when we come back tomorrow, we'll start looking into what she stumbled upon. Anyhow, I'm Lostwolfe. This has been a look at Liliana versus campaign. And tomorrow, we'll start looking at combat a little bit more closely. I hope I see you then. Have a wonderful evening. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope that you're enjoying this as much as I'm enjoying showing it to you. Have a great evening, folks, and good night for now.